What's up, guys? Here we go again. Let me ask a question. Anyone else just sick and tired of this crap with these cops? Why do they think the first option is to pull their guns? There's been so many police shootings, like, of unarmed men, or unarmed black men. What do you think we see? What do you think we think will happen when the first thing we see are guns pointing at us? That's gonna cause some form or something gonna be triggered in us. Now, a man in this case. As a matter of fact, before I even go any further, watch this.
What's going on?
How many occupants are in your vehicle?
It's only myself. Why are your weapons drawn? What's going on?
Open the door slowly. Step out. Open the door.
I'm not getting out the vehicle. What's going on?
Get out the door. Open the door slowly. Get out.
What's going on? My hands are right here. What's going on?
Get out of the car now! Get out of the car!
What's going on?
Get out of the car now! Get out of the car now!
I'm serving this country and this is how I'm treated?
Yo, what's this one? I'm a federal too. I'm gonna obey.
That's
get
not...
out of the car!
What's going on?
Get out of the car now!
What's going on?
What's going on? You're fixing the ride of life,
son. I'm sorry, what?
Now.
What's going
get
on?
Get out the car now! Get out of the car!
Sir, just get out of the car! Work with us and we'll talk to you! Get out the car!
You receive an order! Obey it!
I'm honestly afraid to get out. Can I?
Yeah, you should be. Get out!
What's
get
going
out.
On? What
get
did I do?
Car. Get out now!
I have not committed any crimes.
You're being stopped for a traffic violation. You're not cooperating at this point right now. You're under arrest
for a traffic.
You're being detained. Okay, you're being detained for a
traffic violation. I do not have to get out the vehicle. You haven't even told me why I'm being stopped. Get your hands.
Get out of the car now. Get out of the car.
Get your hands off me, please. Get your hands off me.
You know what?
Get your hands off me. Get your hands off me. I didn't do anything. Don't do that.
Sir, get out of the car
don't
now.
Do that.
Hey,
don't do that.
Now.
Don't do that. I'm trying to talk to you.
Okay.
I'm trying to
I'm
talk to
you. Get out. Just
relax.
Get out of my car.
Can you please relax? Can
get
you
out.
Please relax?
Get out of the car right now.
This is not how you treat a vet. I'm actively serving this country and this is how you're going to treat me? I didn't do anything. Whoa, hold on. What's going on? Hold on. Watch it.
Get out of the car! Get out of the car now!
Sir, just get out of the car!
I'm trying to breathe.
Get out of the car now! Get out of the car and get on the ground now! You're gonna get it!
I don't even want to reach for my seatbelt. Can you?
Take your seatbelt off and get out of the car!
Can you please?
Get out of the car now!
Look.
Listen! Take off your seatbelt and get out of the car.
Look, I'm just gonna just please.
You're gonna do what you're told. Get out of the car.
Look.
Take your seatbelt off and get out of the
look.
Take your seatbelt off.
Look, my hands are out.
Take your seatbelt off and get out of the car.
My hands are out.
Don't reach in there, Daniel. Don't reach in there.
My hands are out. Please. Please. Look. This is really messed up. My dog is in the back. My dog is choking right
now. Get out of the car. Take your seatbelt off. What are you, a specialist corporal? What are you?
I'm a lieutenant.
Lieutenant, get out of the car. Take your seatbelt off and get out of the car. You made this way more difficult than it had to be. You just complied. Get out of the car.
I'm reaching for my seatbelt.
Fine. Take your seatbelt off and get out of the car. Straight onto the ground. Straight onto the ground.
Ma'am,
Is your commanding officer available?
Damn. Let's go.
Is your commanding officer available?
This man in this case, who is a serving member of the U.S. Army, right? You pull him over for a tag you didn't see. Now it's on the vehicle, but you didn't see it. And yeah, I get it. It's supposed to be affixed somewhere visible for anyone to see, right? But you want to tell me, even after he identified himself as a serving member of the Army, you still pepper sprayed him, right? And not only that, you didn't stop there. You finally got out the car, and you still had to put him down on the ground in the U.S. Army uniform after you ask him his rank, right? The man is a lieutenant in the Army, and you still had to put him down on the ground and cuffed him. All the man wanted to know is what is going on. That's all. And what did he do? Right? That's all he wanted to know. What he did. But y'all had to show your power. Y'all had to show your strength. Because you're the master, right? You're the master of a black man. Right? That's it. You have to show that you're the master of the black man. So you can do, no matter what you are or who you are, you're the master. Let's watch some more people.
Turned around and behind you at Food Line. I actually came out of Pulse Plus, and I came up behind you.
I saw you before you turned.
And you had no tag displayed. I see it, but part of the law, it has to be in the license plate, right? I understand the paper and I understand why it's there.
Yes.
But at that time, I had no idea. I didn't know that you had a vehicle registration until I approached your car. And at that point, I was too busy dealing with you to deal with the tag. You want me to wipe your eyes? Okay. So, look, all this was going to be was, hey, man, I stopped you. You didn't have a tag. You got your driver's license. I ran you, and you've been on your way. Okay? It would have been a 2-minute traffic stop turned into all this.
As I was turning, you know, I pulled over to well-lit areas before, and I've never looked out the window and saw a gun blazing immediately.
So the reason we did that was because we followed you for a mile and a half with lights and sirens on, and you didn't pull over. I understand you want to get to a well-lit area, a well-lit area. I get that. But when we follow you that long, look at the climate. This day, and against everybody, against us, against y'all, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm not out to hurt you, and I know you don't want to hurt me. That's not what it's about. What it's about is making sure that everybody goes home at the end of the day. So, when you don't stop and you continue to proceed, our suspicions are raised. What's going on in the car? What don't you want us to see? So you pull into here, and if you were to just comply with the simple commands that we were giving you originally, it would have been done and over with, and you would have got back on the car and you'd be gone by now. But you wouldn't get out the car, you wouldn't comply.
It was just looking out the mirror and seeing the guns out already. That's why I was actually like, what's going on? I was just...
And not to mention, you had
just confused.
I know you weren't reaching, but not to mention, you had a gun at your right leg. You get our perspective there on the safety issue for us as well? You get that?
Yeah, I do, and that's why I put my hands out. I was asking, what do you...
And when you put your hands out, they were like this outside the window. How do we know nothing's in your hands? And I was telling you, stick your hands out. And I was having you step out, and you wouldn't do any of it. You following what I'm saying? okay? So this can go one or two ways, okay? I don't want to hem you up. I'm going to be straight up with you. You're a good man. You've made lieutenant in the Army. How hard is that? That wasn't an easy task, was it?
No, it wasn't.
And what would this do to your career?
It would hurt it. And I'm in the middle of getting promoted right now anyway, so yeah.
So what, captain or first lieutenant?
So first lieutenant.
Okay. So you, and then when we get you out of the car, we have to wrestle with you on the ground just to get your hands behind your back, just to put you in cuffs, just for a safety matter. You follow where we're at? I mean, what would you do if you came across that overseas, you know? If you were infantry and you came across that? You following me? Mm-hmm. You see where we're coming from? I'm trying to work with you as much as I can. I would have never wanted, like I said, it would have been a simple, you know, hey, I see your tag now. You know, make sure you get a display on in the proper spot, and you'd have been moving on with your day, and I'd have been moving on with mine. But here we are.
How's your eyes doing, Lieutenant?
Better.
And I keep calling you, Lieutenant. I told you I'm a veteran. I respect rank, okay? I was a corporal in the Marine Corps. I respect rank. However, I do have a job to do, okay? I just talked about chief of police. You asked for a superior. He's off, obviously, right now. Saturday, I called him. He came out, talked. Here's how he, what I was thinking. I told him what I wanted to do. He said, that's no problem. Two ways we can handle this. We can either sit here with you until you get your eyes back, where you can see, and I mean at a good distance, you're safe to drive, okay? And you're going down the road. Go do your deployment, go continue to serve in my country, which I respect and I thank you for, okay? Or we can push the issue, write you tickets for no license plate display, and for resisting obstruction of justice. I don't even need to go that route, because that route makes the Army get involved, and I know how they are. You don't know this, the Army, he'll vouch for it. Because he's been in and he's got friends that are legal officers, I know. Our military is the only place where, the military is the only place where double jeopardy exists legally. Because whatever we do to him, the Army can turn around and jam for the same thing. I don't want to see that happen. You're obviously a second lieutenant. You ain't been in very long. But if you plan on making a career or even 6 years or whatever, it's up to you. I don't care. There's no need getting this on your record. I don't want your record. However, it's entirely up to you. If you want to fight it and argue, I mean, and I don't mean it disrespectfully, okay? I mean, you have that right as a citizen. If that's what you want, we'll charge you, have you go to court, notify the command, do all that, or we can take time out of our night, which is not a problem. We're being paid to take care of people, okay? We'll sit here with you, get your eyes back. You and, what's your dog's name? Smoke? It's a badass name for a badass dog. You and Smoke can get on down the road, okay? It's entirely up to you. What do you want to do? I ain't got no problem. I'll sit here with you until you get your eyes back and send you on down the road. Okay? I don't want to charge you. I will. It's my job. I don't want to. The chief's giving me discretion on how to handle it. He's like, these are the two choices. I said, that's what I was thinking. That's what I want to do. He's like, not a problem. We can either let it go, help him out, get his eyes back, and get him on down the road so the Army doesn't get involved, or we can charge you and that's a big hassle for you. It doesn't change my life one way or the way. It's, you see what I'm saying? It's not about me. This is about you. What you want to do. If you want to just chill, let this go, and no charges filed, we'll take the handcuffs off, we'll get you a bottle of water to drink on, and sit here until you feel comfortable driving. All right? Mm-hmm. Or the other option is we write the summons, discharge you, have, and we, by then we have no choice. We have to notify your command. And again, I don't have to be an ass. I don't have to be threatening. I say that because that's just the way it is. Okay? I just talked to my boss. Those are the two choices that he gave me. Personally, as a veteran who served, okay, I did 6 years before. My wife's a retired sailor. She was hired as an EA out of the Navy. Okay? I don't want to see you get jammed up by the Army. Okay? I don't want to see it happen. You need to spit. Just let us know. Go ahead and spit. We've both been sprayed, so we know what it's like. It sucks. If you need to spit, go ahead and spit. Yeah, you're not going to offend us. Yeah. All right. What do you want to do, Lieutenant? I'll let you tell me, because...
I mean, nobody's going to ask for charges, so I'm not going to ask for that.
I understand that. However, I have to make that option available to you, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, I have to. So, here's what I want to do. Especially as calm as you've been since everything ended, I'm gonna take the handcuffs off, let you sit here with smoke. We'll sit here and wait with you. Let your eyes come back. Okay, because it takes anywhere from 20 to 40 minutes, depending on how much actually got in the eyeball itself, before you can really see well enough to drive, especially at night. Okay? We'll sit here with you. And then we'll get you on down the road. And the command won't know nothing about it. Alright?
I do have a good rapport with my command, so I wouldn't feel like not talking to them about it. So
well, that's entirely on your own. I'll put it this way then for you. They're going to hear from you. They will not hear from us. I give you that much respect, okay? Because I understand, how I told you, I was in for 6 years. It's always better for the command to hear it first from you than somebody else. Especially law enforcement. That's never a good thing. Go ahead, let's help you. I get it, okay? I get the time that we're in right now. I get it, okay? The time that we're in, the media skewing of the race relations between minority and law enforcement, I get it, okay? So like I told you, as far as you not stopping and if you're uncomfortable and you want to run this spot, because then it happens a lot of times. It happens to me a lot. And it's, I'll say, any kind of time, not always, any kind of time, it's my fault.
What the hell? Where are the stubs on? Yeah, man, we all know that guy full of crap, right? Coming talking all kind of crap. What was the army going to charge the man for? But, you know, we all see how y'all treat those white boys, even after they commit mass shooting, mass murders. You take them to McDonald's, you give them water. Even said they're having a bad day. After killing what? 4 people or more? Man, all I want to know is what will it take to get y'all to stop killing us? Is that how much our lives mean nothing as black people? That's all. That's my question right now.